lot of us have been working from home and having online classes. However, we've also been having problems focusing on work and studies this pandemic, since I have so many days where I cannot focus at all due to the many changes and issues surrounding us. I've put together some practical and sometimes creative tips and tricks which help me personally. I hope that these tips can be of help to you as well. With much ado, let's get to it. Tip number one, designate a study or workstation. The logic behind this is simple. If you dedicate a specific area in your house for working or studying, then your brain and body would be conditioned to think that this is where you are most productive. You don't have to have one specific area. You can beg it to be your dining room, living room, bedroom, even your garden. As long as you can associate working and studying to this specific area, then once you sit down, you would be able to feel like this is a space you are most productive in. In fact, they say changing up your study area enhances recall, so try to study in multiple areas, but take effort to tell yourself that this is an area where I will work and study. When I was studying for a particularly hard exam for my sales class, I went to the living room, sat on the floor, used the coffee table, and laid out all my study materials related to sales there. Whenever I sat down, I knew where everything was, and I had associated that part of the house with my sales class. Sub tip, free your area of clutter. While I agree with Einstein that a cluttered table entails a filled mind, if you're like me and always have the need to tinker with everything and anything I lay eyes on, it's best to keep unnecessary materials away so you can focus on a task. Out of sight, out of mind. I also have a trash can near me so I can keep my workstation clean and clutter-free, but I make sure that it's in a size that allows me to fill it up and throw away the contents immediately. You don't want it to be there for a week, filled to the brim, and having insects crawl their way to the bottom. Tip number two, mimic your routine pre-quarantine. Whether it be putting on work or school clothes, or having a bag filled with things you usually bring to class, doing this helps your body have that sense of normalcy and routine. Just because we're on quarantine doesn't mean we have to throw away the routines that kept us on the go and productive. I try to dress up for class and work as much as I can. It might be because we have video calls, but even if I'm studying alone, having made the effort to dress up makes me feel like it's such a waste if I just lie on the bed in my work or school clothes. If you're used to studying out with a friend, have a family member work with you or ask some friends to do a video call where you just study in front of each other. I know it's weird, but there's a sense of accountability and also shame if you don't work while taking the call. If you don't have a routine pre-quarantine, simply mimicking how your usual day goes will be of help. Sub tip. Do not work or study in your comfortable clothes. Your pajamas may make you feel like you're at home, comfortable, with no one to see you or reprimand you for slacking off, and therefore is one of the unnoticeable deterrents to focusing and being productive. Subtip number two, do not work or study on the bed. I know that working on your desk for hours is hard and straining, but working on the bed most often than not will lead to a snooze fest. I have always fallen prey to this. I get up, lie on the couch or the bed, read a paragraph, and end up going to sleep. Tip number three, make things accessible for you. Just as you have your designated workstation, you should make sure that everything you need is within reach. Create a path of least resistance. Have your books, pens, notepads at the ready. Keep the things you need and use often at arm's length and without anything obstructing your reach. For example, law students always use their CODLs to refer to the law. This is why I always keep my CODLs on my desk and within arm's reach. If I have other things blocking my way, or if they're hidden under a pile of books, it'll become more difficult for me to access them, deterring me from using them, and if I have little self-discipline, which I do, would make me forgo the task altogether. Again, if you also feel the need to use and fix everything you set your eyes on like me, it's best too to prepare and have everything you need at the ready. For example, I always have a pitcher of water and snacks in my study room. While others vote against eating during studying, I know myself and know that I love snacking and it motivates me to work more. Thus, I keep a snack or two or three near me all the time. This is because if I leave and go to the kitchen, I'm almost always tempted to play with my dog on the way, or cook, or bake, or clean the kitchen counter. Just as horses have blinkers, I also try to limit my field of vision to my workstation. Tip number 4. Park it here. A lot of us have a lot in our minds. But how can we effectively focus and accomplish our task if our minds are preoccupied with so many thoughts and worries? Jot down all your thoughts on a notebook or notepad and park your ideas first so you can just focus on the task at hand. You write them down so that they're out of your mind, but you can go back to them later on after you accomplish your task. Tip number 5. Adopt a good study routine or technique. There are so many ways to study. There is no one-size-fits-all way, but I found that trying a proven and tested technique helps up your productivity, especially if you have no work or study routine yet. For me, when I cannot leisurely work and have deadlines to meet and exams to study for, I adopt the Pomodoro style of studying. I study for 25 minutes, have a 5-minute break, and continue and repeat this process. You can definitely customize this according to your attention span. I sometimes customize this to a period of 40 minutes and a 15-minute study break. Speaking of study break, here's tip number 6. Have a study break. Sitting down for hours on end without a break can lead to a slump and prove to be unproductive. Take a short break in between work and study sessions. I say short break because more often than not, having study breaks longer than 20 minutes leads me to lose my momentum, distracts, and then leads me to pursue other interests. Sub tip, have fresh eyes. When you take a break, try to go out of the room or area for a change of view. After being cooped up and narrowing your attention to your laptop or book, a change in scenery will refresh your mind. Whenever I go back to the room, I always feel like it's a new day or a new task because the change in view helped ease my mind. The study break should be long enough to remove the strain from your eyes and body, but short enough not to ruin your flow. If I take a study break and play PUBG or bake, that will take around an hour to accomplish. So instead, I settle with eating a snack, again walking my dog along the street, or watering the plants. Hehe. Tip number 7. Accomplish shorter and easier tasks. This applies if you're not rushing to meet a deadline or trying to study for an imminent exam. I find it best to accomplish tasks that require less energy and time first. This allows me to do and accomplish more in the day instead of focusing all my time and energy over a task that would take hours to finish and eventually drain me. There is also a sense of accomplishment when I see that I've done so much in the day. Tip number 8, prioritize and plan your day. Just because we're at home doesn't mean we shouldn't make use of the planners we bought or collected stickers for. Grab a planner, pad paper, whiteboard, notebook, or anything to plot your day or week out. It helps if you identify the important, urgent, and priority tasks so you know which ones to accomplish first and which ones you can take your time on. Jotting everything down helps you remember them and focus on which ones to accomplish. Be careful not to overplan though. By this, I mean that planning itself makes one feel as if you've been productive, when in fact, you haven't accomplished any of the things you needed to do for the day. If you have specific tasks for the day, I would advise not to detail everything you have, for example, until the end of the year. You can set aside a different time for planning itself. Planning for planning. And finally, tip number 9. Focusing and being productive in the extraordinary times we live in is definitely difficult. Sometimes, not being able to be productive, focus, or accomplish anything can take a toll on our mental and emotional health. So be kind to yourself. There are days when it just doesn't work out the way we want them to, and that's okay. Do what you can for the day, and if you're unable to finish the task, tomorrow is another better day. I hope that these tips will be of help to you in the future, and if you have more tips you can share, please comment it down below. We can use all the help that we can get. Please keep safe, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!